Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I'm Dr. Dafda, and in this 46th video class of DIP, we will study JPEG compression in digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. JPEG is the most widely used lossy image compression format, which is developed by Joint Photographic Experts Group, and hence its name is JPEG. In our previous video class, we learned block transform coding, and JPEG is the best example of block transform coding. So let us start. For transform coding, we transform the image using some transformation and we discard those pixel coefficients that are nearly zero and quantize pixel coefficients which are small, thereby concentrating on only those coefficients which contain the most information about the image. We know that the low frequency components of an image are more important than the high frequency components, and removing 40 to 50% of the bits from the high frequency components may remove, say, only 5% of the encoded information. Now the question comes, which transform to select? The frequency transforms like DFT, DCT or KLT can be used. As we understood in the previous video class, DFT is a complex transform, whereas DCT is only having real part. Blocking artifacts are less pronounced in DCT than the DFT. The DCT is a good approximation of KLT, which is optimal in terms of energy compaction. However, unlike KLT, the DCT has image independent basis functions. What are basis functions? The basis functions are sine and cosine waves with increasing frequencies. And due to all these reasons, the DCT is used in JPEG image compression. In simple way of understanding, JPEG consists of three phases. Divide the image into 8x8 blocks, apply DCT, quantization, and finally lossless compression to each block, and we get the compressed image. These are the equations for forward DCT and inverse DCT, and this shows the DCT basis functions of a 4x4 image, and we can see that it consists of cosines of different frequencies and has only real values. The horizontal frequencies increase from left to right and vertical frequencies increase from top to bottom. The constant valued basis function at the upper left is called the DC basis function. All other are AC components. Comparing DFT, Walsh-Hadamard transform and DCT, we can see that DCT gives more compact transformation, as well as the RMS error, that is the difference between the original image and the reconstructed image, is minimum for DCT. This figure shows the block diagram of JPEG encoder and decoder. First, the image is divided into 8x8 sub-images to speed up the calculations. Next, forward DCT is applied to this block to obtain f of uv. Now, each f of uv is divided by a constant q of uv, which is the quantization table or matrix. JPEG uses quantization table in order to quantize the results of the DCT. See, JPEG is a lossy compression scheme, and quantization allows us to define which element should receive fine quantization and which element should receive coarse quantization. We understood zonal coding and threshold coding in the previous video class, and JPEG uses threshold coding, and using quantization tables, JPEG follows non-uniform quantization. Our eye is more sensitive to low frequencies, that is upper left corner of the frequency matrix, and less sensitive to high frequencies, that is lower right corner. So custom quantization tables can be put in the image header. JPEG standard defines two default quantization tables, one for each luminance and chrominance. After quantization, the values are read from the table and redundant zeros are removed. JPEG uses lossless or entropy coding such as run length coding and Huffman coding at the compression phase. And if we are compressing a color image, then this is the block diagram where initially RGB is converted to Y, CR, CB, and luminance and chrominance are separated. Y is the luminance and CR and CB are the red component and blue component of chrominance. See, our eye is sensitive to luminance and not chrominance, so the chrominance part can lose much data and thus can be highly compressed. The downsampling is done for the colored components and not for luminance. Downsampling is done at a ratio 2:1 horizontally and 2:1 vertically. Thus, the image reduces in size. Since the Y component is not touched, there is no noticeable loss of image quality. To cluster the zeros together, the table is read diagonally in a zigzag fashion. The DC component is coded using DPCM, while AC components are coded using RLE and Huffman coding. These are the steps in JPEG compression. Say, this is an 8x8 block of an image which we are compressing. Next, we do the level shifting, where we shift the levels from 0 to 255 to minus 127 to 127 because DCT requires range to be centered around 0. Next, we compute the DCT using forward DCT equation. This is the quantization matrix or quantization table that is used for quantizing the values obtained after DCT. And these are the luminance and chrominance quantization matrices. So this is the luminance quantization matrix. Now the question may arise in mind that how these quantization matrices are developed. See, these quantization matrices are developed from psychophysical studies having the goal of trying to maximize the amount of compression but also trying to minimize perceptually significant errors. So we will be dividing our DCT matrix or F of UV by quantization table or matrix and round off the values to obtain the quantized values. For example, 312 divided by 16 is equal to 19.5, which is rounded to 20. And similarly, other values are obtained. So hence, using threshold coding, we have obtained these values and all other values are zeros, which are discarded. The zigzag scanning of the coefficients is done because the order of frequency components are from low to high in a zigzag manner, and it also produces maximum series of zeros at the end. The first component is the DC component having average intensity value, and all other components are AC components. The DC component of an image changes slowly and thus encoded using DPCM. The DC component in each 8x8 block is large and varies across blocks but is often close to that in the previous block. So differential pulse code modulation or DPCM encode the difference between the current and previous 8x8 block. Why? Because the difference is a smaller number which requires fewer bits. AC components are encoded first using run length encoding and then using Huffman coding. Finally, we obtain a series of symbols like this. Here, the end of block or EOB symbol denotes the end of block condition. A special EOB Huffman code word is provided to indicate that the remainder of the coefficients in a reordered sequence are zeros. For decoding, the reverse steps are applied. We perform Huffman decoding, run length decoding, and reverse zigzag to get the DCT coefficient matrix. Next, we multiply the DCT matrix by the quantization matrix. After that, we take 2D inverse DCT of this matrix. Finally, we shift the coefficients back to get the reconstructed image. And we can see that the resulting reconstructed image is close to the original image. And remember, this JPEG coding is a block transform coding which we understood in the previous video class. Let us implement JPEG compression in MATLAB. This is the MATLAB program for JPEG compression for grayscale images. And the high quality here means low compression and low quality means high compression. Let us run the program and see the output. So initially it asks what quality of compression you require. Say we require a high quality image. So let us input 90. And you can see that we obtain a very high quality restored image from DCT. So here the compression is very low. Let us again run and now provide the quality 10%. And now you can see that the quality of output or restored image is very bad. This shows the MATLAB program for JPEG compression for color image. And for simplicity, it only uses one quantization table, both for luminance and chrominance. Let us run and see the output. So the compression that is achieved is 16 times. And you can see that even after 16 times compression, the compressed image is almost identical to the original image. But when we zoom, say this particular spice, in both the images, you can see here that the pixels are individually visible and the edges which are visible here are not visible here. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. Thank you very much.